My name is Marie Curie, and I help to change the world in myriad ways. There are, of course, a few choice applications of my initial research that I have no taste for. These are, unfortunately, something we must all live with, thanks in part to me. As a matter of fact, the effects of my discoveries will echo throughout the world for many generations to come. Still, it is an effect I must bear at least some of the responsibility for. This is because I, Marie Curie, dedicated my life to unlocking the secrets of radiation, along with the help of my skillful husband, Pierre. I will not accept, however, that my experiments were nothing more than blind tinkering with the modern equivalent to Pandora's box, as they advanced science past the bounds of what anyone had previously thought possible. What I discovered has helped so many that the good must far outweigh the more devastating energy that radioactive elements contain within them. As you all know, I ended up becoming an unwitting victim of what eventually became known as radiation poisoning. At least your generation knows how to properly handle these substances. While my death was tragic, brutal, and untimely, what I unveiled to the world ended up being worth far more than one life. Even one as brilliant as my own. What is astonishing to me, even now, is how far my legacy has traveled through time. I understood, even at the end, that I had helped advance science past what was previously known, and that my work was monumentally important. Even more impressive is how my achievements have helped spur on countless brilliant women to pursue meaningful careers in science and technology. I am so proud at how far we have come, and hope that my endeavors will continue to inspire young minds towards greatness for generations to come. I was raised to question authority and make my own decisions about the world. My home country of Poland under Russian rule, however, would never make space for a woman. This being so, I moved to Paris in order to complete my studies, pursue my interest in science, and make a name for myself. Sometimes not even I can believe just how much I have radically changed the way people today view the elements. I studied with some of the most brilliant minds the world had ever produced. My instructors included future Nobel laureates and other heavyweights in their fields. Sorbonne is a place of endless knowledge and fascination, with the things that I learned there altering the way I viewed the world in countless ways. Such was my prowess that I received a generous grant to study the effects of magnetism. My husband, Pierre, one of the brightest minds in the field, was already studying magnetism, and soon after we first met, I agreed to share my life with the most engaging man I have ever known. The two of us shared a love of science and each other. For a time, I tried to return to my native Poland, but was unable to find engaging work because I was a woman, and chauvinism was rampant in my lifetime. Unhindered, I returned to Paris and married Pierre, with the two of us helping to push each other to even greater heights. At one point, during the early stages of my research, I heard of a miraculous discovery that I knew would help me along my path to greatness. It seemed that uranium emitted a mysterious radiation, not unlike X-rays. This radiation almost immediately piqued my curiosity. Once I dedicated myself to this new pursuit, I discovered a whole new way of looking at radiation, and saw all the good it could do for the world. Pierre and I always strove to learn as much as we could in our studies, always looking to our experiments for signs of those rays so mysterious that they continued to confound us both. Unfortunately, the rest of the world wasn't quite as forward-thinking as we were. The scientific world was still wary of women to the point where my husband was even nominated for a Nobel Prize as the rest of the community overlooked my achievements, much to my dismay. Pierre, thankfully, insisted that I be recognized alongside him, which helped cement my place as an important and influential scientist. The death of Pierre was a tragic upset in my life, as continuing without the man I had made a life and career with was a difficult proposition. Still, I pressed on and dedicated myself to my work to help relieve my sadness and become a champion of science. I went on to win another Nobel Prize, this time in chemistry, making me the first and only person to win Nobel Prizes in two separate sciences. Throughout the remainder of my short life, I helped to institute mobile radiology units during World War I, and even studied how radiation affects tumor growth. Despite my drive and passion, my work eventually caught up to me, and I was unable to escape the effects of my life's work. My own life was cut short by a bone marrow disease that is seen by many as a side effect of all the radiation I accidentally absorbed during my research. This being so, I am still proud of the discoveries that Pierre and I made together, and my only regret is that we weren't able to share all of my discoveries together.